good to go, Riff.
All right, what's good, YouTube? It's your boy JY, and we've got a deck profile for you guys. We're here with Ben Gregson.
He
came 7th place at the Melksham Regional. It's about 120 something players.
124, I think.
124 players, 7 rounds, and you went
X11.
All right, sick. He played Sky Striker. So yeah, let's get right into it.
Right. So for the monsters, we're on 3 Ray. This is obviously really standard, and then 2 Riz.
Cool.
I was originally playing 1, but the hands where you don't play in Striker are the hands where you lose.
Yeah, yeah.
So just playing the second copy of Rose ensure that always happens.
Okay, sick, sick.
3 copies of Ashes is really standard. It's the only hand trap that hits everything.
Yeah, yeah.
3 Veiler because of Selene and stuff.
Yep.
And then 3 Imperm.
Okay.
And then the weirder Sky Striker stuff. I'm only on 1 Area Zero and the 1 copy of Terraforming.
Right.
So the hands where you brick are usually on Area Zero, but this ensures that you're still playing 2 copies, and this is also just an additional spelling group.
Okay.
They never really conflicted, and genuinely just...
So any Mystic Mine? No?
No, mine's on the side.
Okay, nice,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, we're not playing in the middle.
Okay.
We're hard go first. Nice. 3 Anchor, 2 Shark Cannon. This is the only deck in the game that has an inherent in-deck out, so just removing DPE.
Okay.
Which is the main allure behind it. Also, against like Sword Soul and stuff, you can reborn the Baroness or
nice,
the Baron Floor.
Nice.
So you get additional monster negates, which is really cool.
And I want to ask you, how many scythes did you hit with Shark Cannon?
One.
One? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
But the one scythe that I have, Shark Cannon, just won me the game for free.
Nice.
And then the rest of the one ups, Eagle Booster, Afterburner, Multi-Roll, Drones, and Engage.
Ooh.
So these are additional two additional copies of Ray.
Yeah.
I actually didn't see this in my opening hand at all today.
Like, oh, period. Wow. Okay.
I have not drawn Engage in my opening hand all day.
Rough, and you still grinded out to go X11, yeah. So that's fair, man. Yeah.
Nice. And also, Eagle Boost is really important in this version. Because we're on Hulk, Selene, and we're on Verte, this is just really important to enforce.
Pushes through your OTKs and pushes through your Verte, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That's nice.
2 Mystical Space Typhoon.
Okay, old school.
So I decided to play this over Cosmic because it synergizes with Area Zero.
Fair enough.
There's also situations where you just want a 1-for-1 trade with back row,
yeah.
And you don't want to pay the 1,000 life points because there's certain thresholds,
yeah.
Where you don't die with Kaina if you're at 8k rather than at 7. So this, yeah, is actually really important.
Is there a situation where, like, let's say you had 2 spells engraved and you go engage,
yeah,
chain MST on engage,
yep,
on resolution you get to draw, right? Because
engage
will be engraved. Did that ever come up? Or?
That came up once. It also came up where I MST'd my own back row,
yeah,
to make Kagari big enough to kill somebody today.
Nice,
so,
nice. You do it in the battle phase or,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
nice? You wasn't expecting it, right?
No, absolutely not.
He's a guy.
One Call by the Grave, this should be banned. Rota,
yep,
obviously.
Standard, yeah.
And then 2 Shed Red.
Okay, how'd this work out for you?
It was the best card in my entire deck. So against every deck in the game right now, being like Flunderies, PK, and the worst matchup, which I deem to be the Invoke matchup.
Yeah.
This card allows you to draw into the hand traps and extenders to be able to play 3 bolts.
Yeah.
And on top of that, it's just a spell you can activate, which always allows you to get value off engage. So it's been really good all day.
Nice.
And then the reason to play the deck right now.
Like, just on Shed Ride, that must be like Max C against like the Bird deck, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Nice.
It's Max C against everything.
Yeah.
And the reason to play the deck,
yeah,
is this match.
Yeah, insane.
Got a bit unfortunate against JY where I drew all of this in my opening end, game one. But every time you resolve Fusion Destiny and you have a way to set up Ray or a way to sort of grind is insane. And also, the effect of Celestial allows you to get to Ray in matchups where you don't have it, which is like super important.
Yeah.
The effect of Dasher came up once, so I could actually OTK somebody, and it got Tribute Summoned once today, which was kind of cool.
Probably someone I had a hand trap to OTK with, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Selene combo.
Just to make Hulk Selene.
Nice.
And then, through that can be only one.
This card's insane,
the best floodgate in the format, for sure.
Nice. So, then, 40?
Yeah, 40 in the main.
Okay, cool.
Extras, 2 Hayate. This is deemed as standard if you're playing the Hulk Selene stuff.
Yep.
3 Shizuku.
Yep.
3 Kagari.
Yep.
The 1 Kaina and the 1 Zeke.
Mm-hmm.
Zeke's really important, and I noticed a lot of Striker players aren't utilizing Zeke correctly.
Okay.
So the effect to send cards you control is really, really broken in situations where you need the additional spelling group. And also, it being 25, you can out a card like Dragoon by having Shizuku and Zeke on board. And you can crash your Zeke into that monster and summon your Ray, which happened today as well.
Wow, okay.
And then we're on Anaconda and DPE, obviously.
Yep.
And then Hulk, Selene, Axis Kid. This is the way you kill people. Yeah. Sky Striker wouldn't have a turn 3 game if these cards didn't exist.
Yeah. Nice.
And then the side deck is triple different dimension ground.
Yep.
This is the best card in my deck all day.
Yep.
So the theory behind this is it doesn't really conflict with your deck outside of the DPE package.
Yep.
But every time you're drawing this, you're usually winning the game anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted to play Dimension Shifter, but you can't play in Striker, so this is just the next best thing. And also, I didn't want to lose to blowout cards like Lightning Storm and Evenly.
Yeah,
so this
is
just a chainable card to those cards, which is why I played them.
Yeah, yeah.
Two very unfair Mystic Mine.
Yeah. Did you ever deck anyone out?
No. Oh, okay. No, I actually only sided this in once, but the one game I sided it in, it won me the game. So
yeah.
We take this. Three Evenly.
Yeah, yeah.
Pancratops.
Yep.
Raigeki.
Okay.
This along with Widow Anchor breaks the Soul Sword board, which is why it's in here.
Nice.
And I'm a budget player, so I don't own Lightning Storms, so we won't talk about
this. To be honest, it's probably like better for you because you can draw it in the grind game.
Yeah, exactly.
Whereas Lightning Storm can be dead in the grind, right?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And then the three Cosmic Cyclones and two copies of Solemn Judgment.
Nice.
These were the last two cards on the side. I couldn't really think of what to side.
Yeah.
It was between this and Strike, and I just deemed that this had more matchup potentials and stuff.
Would you have changed anything in the deck?
Honestly, I think the deck's perfectly fine. There's nothing I'd really change.
Okay, sick. And you have a YouTube channel, right?
Yeah, it's Dilemma YGO. It's mostly Zephyr content over there.
Yeah.
But yeah, if you want to come check me out.
Yeah, and your username on Dueling Book is Dilemma as well. He's always like top 10 DB. Like, he's really out there. You top 3 LCSs?
Yeah, we're always on the grand.
He's really, you know, one of the top players out there, especially on Dueling Book. So yeah, watch out for him. Any shout-outs?
Shout-outs to the guys at the Hobby Vault and to Morgan and Lee for driving me up here. And other than that, yeah, we're good.
Sweet. All right. Thank you, and take care, guys.